Hello, welcome again. Today in Vector's third lecture, we are going to see the product of vectors. That means how vectors undergoes multiplication. So we have two different types of vector products that you already know. One is called the dot product, and the other one is called the cross product. So, what is the importance of dot and what is the importance of cross? All will be taught to you in great detail. In today's lecture, we are going to devote this entirely in the dot product, and in the next lecture, we are going to discuss only on the concept of cross product. So, what exactly is a dot product? Now, suppose if you have a vector A and say that you have another vector B, and I want to multiply these two vectors and say that they make an angle of theta. Now, what is the component of A along B? So if I try to do a resolution of vector over here, then the vector A along the baseline will have a component of A cos theta, and along the perpendicular line will have a component of A sin theta, correct? So I can multiply the vector A with B in two ways. Either I can multiply its base component with B, or I can multiply its perpendicular component with B. So when I multiply the base component with B, I am multiplying two vectors which are parallel to each other. Okay, and when I multiply the perpendicular component with B, I am basically multiplying the perpendicular components of two vectors. So in dot product, we multiply these two. Okay, same direction, which are in the same direction, and in cross product we multiply these two, which are in perpendicular direction. That is the reason why. When you write A dot B, we write this as A B cos theta, correct? Now if you see here, there is a B here, so you can see a B here, and then you can see a cos theta, and this is your A cos theta. So A dot B is always equal to A B cos theta, okay? What about your cross product? We write cross product as A cross B, and that is equal to AB sine theta, and cross product always comes with the direction, so we also write a n cap over here. Now you can see here it has a B and then it has A and sine theta. So this is your A sine theta. Okay. So that's the first glimpse of dot product or cross product. You have either AB cos theta as dot product or A cross B, that is AB sine theta. And this A and B over here are the modulus, the magnitude of A and B. Same thing over here, this is the magnitude of A and B. Okay, so we will continue our class today with the concept of dot product. Okay, now, and we will reserve the cross product for our next lecture. So this is my formula for dot product. The important thing that dot product, when you multiply two products under dot multiplication, this result which you obtain, the result thus obtained is a scalar quantity. Okay, this you should know, that in dot product, the final product is a scalar quantity. So this is a scalar quantity. Okay. Now, how do we use vectors in our especially the dot product? Okay, and what are the importance of dot product? And if you ask me, dot product, I believe it's easier to understand. It has more application than cross product. Okay, it helps us in a lot of way, and especially the most important thing is it helps us to get the angle between the two vectors. Okay, so we are going to see one after another. And I'm expecting that you people are aware of this I, J, K component. So we are going to discuss the concept of A and B, A vector and B vector in terms of I, J and K. Now those who don't know may not be knowing I, J, K. I is the unit vector along x-axis, J is the unit vector along y-axis, and K is the unit vector along z-axis. Okay. So how do we do the dot product over here? Now before, there are certain rules over here. So when you multiply two unit vector I dot I, dot I must be equal to 1. Okay, y I dot I is 1 because this is unit, this is also unit. So unit multiplied by unit is unit only. And why it is 1? Because I and I cap and I cap both are in the same direction. I and I both are in the same direction. What does the formula say? Formula says I dot A dot B equals to A B cos theta. So what does the formula say? The formula says over here A dot B. So A B cos theta, correct? A dot B is equal to A B cos theta. Now, this is the mod of unit vector. This is the mod of unit vector. So, mod of unit vector is 1. Mod of unit vector is 1. What is the angle between I and I? Both are I. That means both are in the x direction only. Sorry. Both are along the x direction only. If both are along the x direction only, that means what is the angle between them? So, if both are in the same x direction, the angle between them is 0 degree. Correct? If angle between them is 0 degree, what is cos 0? Cos 0 is 1. So you will get 1 here, you will get 1 here, and this cos 0 is 1. So entire thing you will get as 1. So we use the rule that I dot I is equal to 1. Okay. Similarly, we can write J dot J is equal to 1, K dot K is equal to 1. And what about the rest combinations like I dot J? This will be 0. What about your J dot K? This will be 0. What about your I dot K or K dot I, whichever way you can take, that is also equal to 0. Now why it is 0? Now how I can write I dot J? I can write I dot J as I, J, that means A dot B equals to A B cos 90. Why 90? Because I cap is along x axis and J cap is along this axis. And what is the angle between them? Angle between them is 90. So A dot B equals to A B cos 90. And cos 90, we know that cos 90 is 0. So the entire thing becomes 0. So these rules are very important. I dot I is 1, I dot J dot J, and so on. Now let's go to the IJK format. So the types of questions which they may ask, direct questions. Direct questions like vector A, vector B is given to you, find the dot product. Direct. Okay, vector A, vector B is given to you, find the dot product. For example, I'll just give you the examples, okay? For example, let us say A vector A is 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. And you have vector B. Vector B is equal to, say that 4i cap plus 2j cap plus 1k cap. So you have to find what is the value of A dot B. Direct question. What is the value of A dot B? So how will you find the value of A dot B? Value of A dot B you can find as the value of A dot B. Okay, is equal to, now write A. A is 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap dot 4i cap plus 2j cap plus 1k cap. Now you start. Basically, you have to just think about the same component, ii component, jj component, kk component, because rest other combinations will be 0. For example, when you multiply 2 with 4, 4 into 2 is 8, and you are multiplying I dot I. Okay, you are multiplying 2 and 4, so 4 2s are 8, and then you are dealing with I dot I, that is 1, plus other combinations of 2, that is 2 with 2, I dot J will be 0. Then 2 with this one, so I dot K will be 0. That means 2 is only multiplied with the I component here. So only the II, the JJ and the KK component gets multiplied in dot product. Okay. Similarly, if I start with 3, 3 4s are 12, no use because it is J dot I, that becomes 0. Then you have 3 into 2, 6, and then you have J dot J, that is important. So 3 2 just 6. So 6 you will get over here, plus 4 into 1, that is 4. And hence the answer is 8 plus 6 is 14, and 14 plus 4 is 18, and your answer is 18 unit. the concept of work done, which you learned in class 10, also falls under dot product. Okay. So the body is displaced. So let us say if I consider a Cartesian coordinate system, let us say the body was initially here and then it has been displaced to somewhere here. Just take a random variable, somewhere here. Okay? Just take. So this will not be given to you in the question. They will just give you that, they will just give you in this manner that a body is acted upon by a force such that the body is displaced from one position to another position. And that value will be given to you from one position. One position means this is one position. Let us call this as R1 to another position R2, and this R1 and R2 will be given to you. So I am giving the value of R1 and R2. So let us say R1 and R2 is 1 I cap plus 2 J cap plus 3 K cap, and R2 is equal to 3 I cap plus 2 J cap plus 1 K cap. This I have given to you. So you have to basically, so it was here and then this force starts acting and the body has reached here. That means the body has undergone this much of displacement. This is my delta R. Okay. So how will you find the delta R? Now here, if you remember the previous lecture, you can see here R1 plus delta R is equal to R2. Can you see that vector addition? Tail head tail. So I will write R1 plus delta R equals to R2. This implies delta R equals to R2 minus R1. So basically you have to subtract this two to get the displacement delta R. So delta R is equal to, just subtract the R2 minus R1. R2 minus R1. So 3 minus 1 is 2 I cap. 2 minus 2 is 0 J cap. 1 minus 3 is minus 2 cap, 2 K cap. Okay, so I got the value of delta R. Now what is the force? Force is 2 I cap plus 4 J cap plus 2 K cap. Ultimate question, find the work done. So how will you find the work done? Work done is force dot, those who are learning this for the first time, work done is defined as force dot displacement. Remember in class 10 you used to write Fs cos theta. The moment it was S cos theta, all teachers were knowing at that time is dot product, but none of the teachers will tell told you at that time, right? Because we don't introduce dot product in class 10. So F dot delta R is the formula. Delta R represents the displacement over here. Okay, so I just take our dot product over here. So what is F? F is 2i cap plus 4j cap plus 2k cap dot delta R. Delta R is 2i cap plus 0 j cap. If you want to write 0 part, you write, otherwise you can just leave it. Minus 2 k cap. And now simplification. 2 2's are 4. 4 into 0, 0. 2 into minus 2, minus 4. Work done, 0. 0 joule. Okay, in this question we are getting 0. Always you will not get 0, don't worry. Sometimes you will get a value of 0. Minus 2 is 0, 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Yeah, looks good. 2ik plus 4jk plus 2kk. Yeah, looks good. Okay, and we can justify over here that why it is 0, but later on, not today. It is 0. Okay, thank you. So this is how we do for the work done concept. Okay. Now the another important part is consider the example 3 part. Dot product is also very useful for finding the angle between two vectors. This is most important part of dot product. Whenever you encounter a question in IJK form and the question says find the angle between the two vectors, just jump into the dot product concept right away, okay? Without any second thought. If it is in the IJK format, right away jump into the question by applying the dot product. So for example, I have a vector A. Let us say I have a vector A. Vector A is I cap plus 1 j cap plus 2 k cap as vector A, and I have vector B as 4 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap, and I want to know what is. I'm just giving a random question, okay? But this is how the questions will be like. So I want to know what is the angle between these two vectors. So in a space, if somewhere here I have a vector, if somewhere here I have a b vector, okay, a vector and b vector like this, let us say one half, I have a vector, I have a b vector, and I want to know what is the angle between the two vectors. I want to know what is the angle between the two vectors a and b. So how to do that? So for that we use this concept of a dot b. A dot b equals to a b cos theta, okay, and hence what is the value of cos theta? Cos theta will be is equal to a dot b divided by a mod and b mod. This is the formula to find the value of the angle between the two vectors. Okay, now let's start doing it. So first we have to do with the numerator part. The numerator part is a dot b. A dot b will be equals to, a dot b. You can use step by step procedure, or we can right away use the concept of a dot b. A dot b, if you see here, it is in board exams you have to show the working. In entrance and all, if you are knowing, just write 2 4s are 8, 1 2s are 2, 2 3s are 6, okay, divided by mod of A. What is mod of A? How to find mod of any vector? I hope that part is clear to you. So if any vector is given to you, here I will write. Suppose if I have a vector, let us say called A, as x I cap plus y j cap plus k k cap z k cap, then how to find the mod of A? The mod of A will be equal to the magnitude. The magnitude will be equal to root over of x square plus y square plus z square. Okay. This is the formula we use. So we will use the value of, what is the value of A? Root over of 2 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. So this becomes 4 plus 1 plus 4. So you have 4, okay, I will write like this. 2 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. And then you have mod of B. Dot, multiplied here. Okay, this is multiplied by B. So what is the value of B? 4 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. 4 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. And square root over that. And that is equal to 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 6, 16. So this is 16 divided by, this is 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. So this will be a root over of 9, which will come out as 3, and this will be 4, 4 is 16, 16 plus 9, 25, 25 plus 4, 29. I'll repeat, 4, 4 is 16, 16 plus 4, that's 20, 20 plus 9 is 29. So, root the power of 29. This is my value of cos theta. Sometimes you get a standard values, sometimes you don't. When you don't get those things, you have to use scientific calculator, or if it is not divisible further, you will find in options also, if it is objective type questions, you will find the options also like this. Okay, so you can at the most you can write the 3 over here if you want to simplify. So 16, 3 root 29, and you can also write this as theta equals to cos inverse of 16 divided by 3 root 29. Or if you have a calculator, you can, you are most welcome to calculate this. So this is the most important part. How do we get A dot B as this? Okay, so suppose if I just have to slightly modify the formula, correct? Let us say, I will not do the entire thing, I just modify it. Suppose you have a minus term over here, If you have a minus term over here, that will not affect the mod, because mod square of negative is positive only. So mod remains same. The only difference is this, the last term, the k component part. 3, 2, 6. So this part will become minus. Correct? And that will change this part as 8 plus 2, 10, and 10 minus 6 as 4. So this becomes 4. This becomes 4. And this becomes 4. If you make this as minus. So I just taught you with minus also, and I just taught you with plus also. Okay? Two questions in one. Alright. Then you will find this type of question which are very, very important. This one, example 4, is very, very important. It is extremely important. In this question, what we have to do is, there will be a condition given to you. Condition will be given to you. For example, if I have a value of A, let us say as 2i cap, I always start with 2, I don't know why. Okay, so let us say 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 5k cap, and then you have another vector B which is equal to 2i cap plus 3j cap plus xk cap. Let us say unknown quantity, let us say B. And I will, just for sake of simplicity, I will use a minus sign here and there, so that, okay. So 3i cap plus 4j cap minus 5k cap, and B vector is 2i cap minus 3j cap plus B k cap. Now the condition is this, what should be the value of B? Okay, there will be a confusion, so I will just use this as M. All the there only. TK cap. So the question is like this: what should be the value of T so that A and B are perpendicular to each other? So that vector A and vector B are perpendicular to each other. That's the question. Okay. Here is the thinking, the thought process. Thought process is like this. If A and B are perpendicular to each other, their dot product must be equal to 0. Because dot product for two components which are perpendicular, remember the formula, A dot B equals to AB cos theta. What do we know? We know that we have A dot B equals to A B cos theta. Now what is the angle if it is 90 degree? If the angle between the two vectors is 90 degree, then I can write this as cos 90. What is cos 90? Cos 90 is 0. That means A dot B will become 0. So if two vectors are perpendicular to each other, the dot product between them must give you the value of 0. Clear? So let's do it. So let's find the value of A dot B. What is A dot B now? A dot B will be equal to, just do the dot here, 3 2s are 6, 4 3s are 12 with a minus sign. So minus 12. And then you have minus 5 into t. So minus 5t. And this must be equal to 0 because the condition says that two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So I'll just, for the sake of simplicity, I will write here, find the value of t for which A vector is perpendicular to B vector. Okay? This is a symbol for perpendicular. For which A vector is perpendicular to B vector. So I am doing that part. So over here now this implies 6 minus 12 is minus 6 equals to, take this 5t on that side, so it becomes 5t. Okay. So this implies you will get this as 5t equals to minus 6. Okay. So this implies your t will be equal to minus 6 by 5, and that is your answer. So this is how we get the unknown parameter for a given condition. The condition is A and B are perpendicular to each other. So we can find an unknown component if the condition of perpendicularity is given to us. Okay, this is very important. This is very, very important. Just take a dot product and equate to 0. The last part. I'll again start from the beginning. If this is my A vector and if this is my B vector, this angle was theta. So what is this component? This component is A cos theta. So we know that A dot B is equal to A B cos theta. This implies A dot B, if I divide this by B, what will I get? I will get this value of A cos theta. What is A cos theta? What is A cos theta? A cos theta is a component parallel to B. Similarly, A dot B divided by A will be is equal to B cos theta. So instead of resolving A as A cos and A sin, what if I resolve B as B cos and B sin? Okay, I would have got the same. So what I mean to say here is this. If you find A dot B and you divide by B, what you get? You get a component of A parallel to B. This is component of A parallel to B. And if you divide, if you do A dot B and divide by A, then you get B cos theta. What is B cos theta? B cos theta is component of B. Component of B parallel to A. Just know this now. Okay? It's very easy to get. Because you know how to do A dot B. If I'm asking you to find the component of B parallel to A, then you divide by A. If I ask you to find the component of A parallel to B, then you divide by A. Okay? So that's it. These are our applications of dot product. Practice some questions to have a good hand in this topic. Okay, thank you for watching.